At the heart of every galaxy lies one of the most mysterious objects in the universe, a supermassive black hole. Millions to billions of times the mass of our sun, these giants power astrophysical jets, one of the most energetic processes known to physics. In 2019, the Event Horizon Telescope released this picture of the heart of M87, the first ever image of a black hole. A second image, released in March 2021, is helping astronomers understand the inner workings of astrophysical jets and the celestial giants that fuel them.
A quasar is a massive black hole that resides in the nucleus of most galaxies like our own and is smaller than our solar system, and yet, through a variety of mechanisms, it is able to outshine the whole galaxy around it. So it is a very mighty engine that's very small, that is very, very powerful. If you look at the essential features of what we currently think is going on in the tiny nuclei of these galaxies, is that firstly, there is a black hole there which has this mass, but it has one other property which I believe to be very important, which is that it is spinning.
As a black hole spins, it draws charged particles, known as plasma, into its gravitational pull. These particles create a magnetic field that ejects energy thousands of light years into space.
Jets themselves comprise very hot gas and magnetic field, which together move with a speed that is very close to the speed of light. And following the precepts of special relativity, that means that any radiation that they emit will be beamed along their direction of motion.
In 1918, Heber Curtis discovered the first jet, which he described in his notes as a curious straight ray. As it turned out, that jet belonged to the supermassive black hole in M87.
So it's a rather special object in the life of an astronomer. I was a research student in Cambridge University in the early 1970s. This was in some sense a golden time for black holes. My friend and colleague Roman Znajek and I, we came up with a process which was able to extract energy from the spin of a black hole with an efficiency of roughly a half, and then we said, well, maybe this is the power source for the jets and much else besides.
The Blandford-Znajek process describes how a spinning black hole twists its magnetic fields into coils. This motion creates a current of electrons and positrons that flow out from the black hole in both directions, accelerated by the twisting magnetic fields. But until the recent Event Horizon Telescope image, this process was just a theory.
So what we see in our image is a spiral structure of the polarization, which tells us that the magnetic field is also spiral. To have a Blandford-Znajek process, first of all, you need ordered magnetic fields, which is what we see. Our image is ordered. And the spiral structure tells us that there's a component in the magnetic field around the disk, but there's also a vertical component, which means that there is a magnetic pressure that pushes out gas very close to the black hole. And this is also what the Blandford-Znajek process predicts. And this vertical component, we think, is a direct link to how the black hole is able to launch this jet. It is the most energetic process or powerful process in our universe.
These tiny nuclei, smaller than the solar system, but containing massive black holes, can produce as much energy over their lifetimes as the stars that surround them. And so when we ask, well, how is the universe powered? Yes, there's gravity. Yes, there are stars. But these tiny but mighty galactic nuclei are big players too. And so they have a large role in the growth of what we see in the universe around us.